Hi everyone, I hope you are very well and healthy. Welcome back to another lecture in water supply and sewerage course. Today we are going to talk about the intakes and the intake of the water treatment plants and how to take and design the pipelines in the intakes. As we talked about that, we say that we have different, as you can see in the slides, we have different types of intakes, and we have to be aware how to design and how to take the intakes. We talked a lot about the screens, the first step of the first step in the steps in the intakes. There should be a screen, and there should be installed screens, and we have two types of screen. We have bar screens, and we have mesh screens. And the bar screens that we have fine, we have coarse, we have medium, based on the spaces between the bars. And based on that, we have to be aware the velocity through the bars should be between 0.3 to 0.6 if we have coarse, and we have less than this one if we have mesh screen. Yes, so today we are taking how to design the water pipelines, the pipelines that convey water from the shore to the sump tank. As you know that we have a river, we have a shore, we have a stream, and we have to send water to the treatment plant, and they should not be directly, there should be a sump tank, and there should be a pipe that's connecting between the shore and the sump tank. For these types of pipes or conduits, we have to design the pipelines based on the flow, the maximum requirements of the people, and that maximum should be maximum monthly. And as we know, the maximum monthly, as you can see, is equal to average monthly times 1.4. This is a peak factor for the monthly. And for the city, if we know the population of that city, so population times the water consumption times 1.4 will give you the maximum consumption per month. And we should be aware that also we need to know how much is the minimum flow that can these pipes or these conduits that handle, which is equal to 70% of the average, 0.7 of the average of the monthly. Now we have three levels. We have 3 points: average, we have maximum monthly, we have minimum monthly. So these three cases, they should have the velocity of the water through these pipes should be within three cases. The first one, in normal case, it should be more than 0.6 meter per second. This is called a self-cleaning velocity, which is not let to settle down the clay and the sand and the other particles to settle in the pipes. So the self-cleaning means due to that velocity, everything will be removed and not settled in the pipes. Also, the velocity should not be more than 1.5 to prevent pipes scouring. In case of emergency, let's say if we have three pipes and one of the pipes are out of duty, then we should these two pipes, the other two pipes, the other rest pipes should handle the same quantity of the water, and definitely there will be higher velocity that we have. So this velocity should not also be more than 2.5 meters per second. The pipe numbers or the number of the pipes already should be more than 2. And we have 2 and plus 1 plus 2 and so on. The diameter of the pipes that we have, it should be more than 200, 300. These are the standard pipe diameters that we have. Okay, now here's the steps of the design in the pipes. First of all, we have to find the maximum monthly flow, which is equal to average monthly consumption times the population, and which is give you the average consumption, and after that multiplying by 1.4, then we will get the maximum monthly, and also the minimum monthly, which is equal to average monthly times 70% or 0.7, and this is 1. Assume, so now we have the flow in the pipes. So I should have flow for per each pipe. We will assume the velocity in the pipe should not exceed 1.5. So you are free to assume a velocity between 1 and 1.5. This first assumption. And we will assume a velocity, and then we will back to check that velocity again. Based on this assumption, when we know that velocity times area of the pipes will give you, it will equal to the flow during these pipes. So I have a velocity, so I can find the number of the pipes and even the pipe diameter that's satisfied with this kind of flow. Now we will stand with the number of the pipes, and then we will find the flow diameter. These are the diameter of the pipes. So the two V actual, which is equal to Q maximum monthly divided by the N number of the pipes, and the area of one pipe. So here is the number of the pipe, and here is the area of a cross-sectional area of one pipe. So this velocity should not exceed 1.5, and it should be more than 0.6 actually. Minimum velocity, which is equal to Q minimum, it should be more than 0.6. So the Q minimum divided by N number of the pipes and area of each pipe will give you that much. In case of emergency, then when there will be one of the pipes out of duty, so N minus 1 times will give you, should be 2.5. In case that these are not satisfying, so we have to use another number of the pipes plus 1. Let's solve an example on that base. Now, as you can see here in this example, we have the population is equal to 200,000 capita, and we have the water consumption, which is equal to 200 liter per capita day. Now, average consumption solution, this is solution. Average consumption, or Q average, which is equal to population times water consumption per liter or per person. 200, by the way, this is the forecasted per population, times, if it wasn't forecasted, you should forecast it by using either arithmetic or geometrical method or any other methods that you know. Times 2 liter, which is equal to 0.2 liter, it becomes meter cube per capita per day, and this is per day, which is equal to 40,000 meter cube per day, and is equal to is equal to 40,000 divided by 24 times 3,600. Yes, so it's equal to 40,000 divided by 24 hours divided by 316 to get per second, which is equal to 0.463 meter cube per second. And this is the average. Now I want to know how much is the maximum. The maximum one, maximum monthly, so Q maximum monthly is equal to Q average times 1.4. Also Q minimum is equal to Q average times 0.7. So times 1.4 will equal to 0.648 meter cube per second, and times 0.7 will give you 0.324 meter cube . Yes, it was 0.648. The average one is 0.463, and the minimum is 0.324. Now, these should be supplied with water, with three pipes or four pipes. I don't know. So how many pipes? So this is the this kind of pipes will represent how much it should be. How much is the number of the pipe that should deliver water to this from the shore? So we have the water is going through these pipes and going to the south. Now we will assume a velocity. Assume a velocity or in pipe, in the pipes, it should be between one. I will assume it's 1.4 meter per second. It should be between 1 to 1.5 meter per second. So this is my assumption. And I will check the diameter of the pipes. Now, as you can see, Q is equal to velocity times the area of the pipes. So here is the velocity. So flow Q is equal to area times the velocity. Now area is equal to pi d square over 4, and so we have the velocity, we have the area, we need the area. And now area is equal to Q divided by V, and it's equal to at maximum use, so it's equal to 0.648 divided by V 1.4. This is meter cube per second. This is meter per second. Now it should equal to a number of the pipes times pi d square over 4 for each pipe. So divided by 1.4. will give you divided by it will give you 0.463 meter per meter square, and in this way use n equal to 2 find phi or diameter. And this way is equal to, if I'm using 2, if I use in n and I use n, I will use 2, I will find diameter. So I using 2, that will get me. So yeah, by using n equal to 2 times pi d square over 4 will equal to 0.463, and this way d square is equal to 2 times 0.463 divided by 3.14, the pi, it will equal to d square is equal to 0.294 meter square. Now d is equal to 543 millimeter, and we don't have this kind use 530. Why? Because 550. So you have to use 550 millimeter as a standard pi. At n equal to 3, so 3 times pi d square over 4 will equal to 0.463. And from here, d square will equal to 0.75 times 0.463. Sorry, 0.4. Six three divided by 0.75 divided by 3.14. So yeah, d square is equal to 0.197, and from here now diameter will equal to 443 millimeter, and you can use 415 millimeter, and this is the most very good one. So I will use in case of using diameter equal to 450 millimeter, I will check. I check the velocities. Now, velocity, actual velocity is equal to q divided by area of each pipe. Now, q is equal to q maximum monthly, and this is equal to 0.463 divided by n number of the pipes, and area of each pipe is equal to pi d square, which is equal to 0.45 square divided by 4, pi d square over 4, and this will be it's equal to 0.971 meter per second, and it's okay, it's greater than 0.6 meter per second and less than 1.5. okay, now let me check with the minimum one also. V minimum, well, in case of Q minimum divided by A, and Q minimum is point. Q minimum is equal. Q minimum, yes, here's Q minimum is equal to 0.7. 0.324 meter cube per second, and area of the pipes, three pipes, pi d squared 0.45 square over 4, and it's equal to 0.324 And in this way, it's equal to 0.68 meter per second, and also it's greater than 0.6. Okay. Now we need emergency case. V is equal to Q divided by N minus 1 pi d squared over 4. And here a 0.463 divided by n minus 1, and it means 3 minus 1, it means 2 pi d squared, which is 0.45 over 4. And it's okay, it's equal to 1.45 meter per second, which is also less than 2.5. Then okay, this is also okay. Now we have another thing. So we designed the pipes that's coming, so three pipes will be enough. Three pipes, each pipe of 450 millimeter is the total required pipes that to convey from here to there, just for the sump. Now how to design the sump, and as you know, the sump is here, we have pumps, so pumps is required to be designed, and also the sump. For the pump, here's the pumps. So to design the sump tank, we need to know how much is the volume of the required of the sump, and how much is the volume of this tank, and also we need to know how much is the capacity of the pumps that's required to be installed for that sump. Now for the sump tank, the tank that's collecting water from the pipes, it should be capable to handle the input water from the shore, from the river to this tank and then to the pumps. So the total process should not take longer than minutes. So in the worst condition, we have to know we have maximum monthly, we have minimum monthly. The volume of this tank should be a maximum of 2 minutes of the maximum monthly. As we know, Q is in terms of liter cube per T time, and here is time, so the result is liter cube, oh sorry, volume L cube. So you should take care, you have to take either the maximum monthly times 2 minutes or the minimum times 5 minutes. Which one of them maximum show? So the volume of the sum should supply should be capable to handle the one. The dimension of the sums, if we so now we have the Q. Now the dimensions of that sum. So here's the pipes. Here's the pipes. And here's the pipes. So only that here's the stream. So these pipes are taking water from here to there, and we know that we have a pumps here, we have another pumps here, and so on. So we have the length. Here's it's called the length. So the lengths of the pipes are, so here's the length. The length of the pipe, the length of the sump, here's some, this is called sump. So the length of the sump is equal to the number of the pumps that we have. Number of the pumps and the dimension between 1 to 3. So you have to allocate for each pump about 1 meter minimum and 3 meters maximum. So between 1 to 3, it's allowed to you. And the L is also, the L is the length. The B is the length of a pump. Now, what remains is the height of this tank. The height of this sump tank, usually it should be volume divided by L divided by B. Now, this is area. This is the gross basement area. Now, I have the volume of this tank from this equation, and I know the number or the length and the width of the pump. So what remains is the depth of the sump, and the depth it should be equal to volume divided by length times B. And by the way, this depth should be greater than the D minimum. How much is the minimum depth of the tank that should be required? It's equal to, this is the D minimum. The D minimum is equal to at least 50 centimeters should be the tank beneath the bed level. And also we have this level, and so this level is equal to low water level. Low water level, it means Q minimum. So at low water level minus how much is the friction that we have. So these pipes will take in water from here to there. So there will be a head loss from here to there. So the low water level minus the total head loss, which is called the friction loss, will give you this level. And so the D minimum is equal to the elevation of the low water level minus head loss, which is here. Minus the level A minus the bed level plus 50. So this level minus this level will give you the dimension from here to there plus 50 centimeter, or 15 will give you the design bed of this river. And with respect to pump, the pumps should need, we have to have the head of the pumps. The head of the pump is equal to, or it's called total head. It's equal to static head and dynamic head. The static head is how much is the level of the first unit that's coming after the pump, or the pump is conveying water from here to there. So the difference between this point and this point will call static head. About the dynamic head, the dynamic head is how much is the friction, how much is the friction loss, how much is the velocity, and how much is the losses. The losses are is between sending water from here to there. So we have the length of this pipe. The length of this pipe, and we have the diameter of this pipe. So the friction loss is equal to F L over D V square over 2G. L is the distance from here to there. D is the diameter or phi from here to there. And F is the friction factor, and velocity is the Q divided by the diameter of the pipes. This is all related to the design of the sump and the pumps and the intake. So let's go back to solve an example on this. Okay. So yeah. This example say okay, so to design the water, so we have the sump. Now here is the sump, and we have the river here, and we design the pipes that's delivering water from this one to the sump, and inside the sump there's a pumps. And the pump is sending water to another tank, which is higher than its value. So the level here minus the level here is going to give you a static head. Anyway, so the first unit treatment is 20, so plus 20, and this sump is the low, the water level in the sump. Here is the water level on the sump. Here is equal to 11.5. So we have to know then the flow is the average water treatment plant of flow. The Q is equal to 2000 meter cube per hour. This is the average. Now what to do? We have to find the volume of sump, and it's equal to either the 2 minute times Q maximum monthly, or equal to my 5 minutes times Q of minimum. So it's equal to 2 minutes times the Q in maximum monthly. Maximum monthly, it means equal to 1.4 times 2000 meter cube per hour. And in Q minimum is equal to 5 minutes times 0.7 times 2000 meter cube per hour. So which one of them will give you a maximum? You have to take it. Now, first of all, 2000 meter cube per hour, it means 2000 meter cube per hour divided by 360, it's 0.556 meter cube per second times 2 times 60. So here is the volume is equal to 66.67 meter cube. And in this case, 5 times 0.7 times 2000 divided by 3600. Here is we have, sorry, we have 1.94 meter cube per second. And by the way, this is wrong. We have to 2002 times, sorry, 5 minute times 60 times 0.7 times 2000 divided by 3600. Yes, sorry. So 2 minutes divided by 60 times 1.4 times 2000. Here we have 96. Sorry. 93.3 meter cube we have 100, we have 116. Yeah, now we have two volumes, so which one is greater? Now I will take this one into consideration. Now we have the volume of the sump is equal to 100 Okay, let me check because I think we have something wrong. 0.7, yeah. 0.7 times 2000 divided by 60 divided by 1.4. Yes, so now the volume of the sump 1.667 meter cube, and we can use from 1 to 3. Now, based on the requirements, we can use, here's the tank. The tank should be like this. Now, the number of the pipes that we have, and then L, B, and the H. Okay, and N, I will be, this is L, sorry, so N number of the pipes, number of the pumps, 3 times 1, it's the length. I will, for each one, for each pump, I should allocate between 1 to 3 meters, so I will allocate 1.5, so L is equal to, yeah, L equal to 3 times, so I will assume 4.5, and B is equal to from 1 to 3, now I will assume 2 also, so B is equal to between 1 to 3, I will use 2 meter, 4.5 meter. So L times B is equal to 4.5 times 2, which is equal to 9 meters squared. Now, how much is the H? The H is equal to volume divided by area, which is equal to 1106.67 divided by 9. So the result is equal to 12.96 meter. Use 13, or let me 14 meter. Why 14 meters? So I will use 14 just for case we have head losses or something else. So this is for design, related design of the sump volume. Now I want to design the pumps. For the pumps, we have to know how much is the head, total head of the pumps. It's equal to static plus dynamic. The static is the difference between the first and the second, the first step and the swamp. First step, which is a clarifier. So I say that the level is about 20 meter. It's about 20 plus 20. And here we have 11.5. So 20 minus 11.5 will give you 8.5, and in this way meter is the static head. The dynamic head, the dynamic head is equal to FL over D, V square over 2G, and F is the friction factor that we have. You can follow the steps that we have in the slides, and it will be easy to find the head total. The head total, when it was founded, so we just need to have the power, the capacity of the pump, the powers. The power is equal to head of the pump times as you can see here. Yes, so the 8.5, here's the 8.5. Okay, so the head between this is the first and this is the sump. Now we have 8.5 meter difference, so this is called the static head. The dynamic is the required is for friction, for secondary, for velocity. For secondary is equal 10 to 20% of the losses. For velocity is equal to v square over 2g. Now what's remain? What remain gamma of water? We have it is equal to 9.8. We have the monthly and monthly peak factor, monthly moment. We have the total, and after that, finding this is two efficiencies. Any pump have its own efficiency for removing, and the for motor. So it's equal to 0.7 times 0.6, and in this way we have a pump of 106 meter. Now how to check? To check this one, we have to have the this is for the depth of the minimum. Show we have to have the minimum. The minimum is 8.5, so the D is equal to V sum over L over V. By this one, this way we will come to the end of this presentation. I hope you all to rewatch again and again this calculation and do the rest of the calculation in your notebook. Thank you very much for attending and watching my video. Bye bye.